Welcome to Chesapeake Treasure. I'm Pete Lesher, Chief Curator for the Chesapeake Bay Maritime Museum, and today I have a couple of navigational instruments which we have selected for our upcoming exhibition, Exploring the Chesapeake, Mapping the Bay. Now, these of course are not maps, but these are instruments that that get used along with charts for navigation on the Chesapeake. And these both have a little bit of age to them. The first one of them is an octant, so named because it has an arc that represents 1/8 of a circle, with degrees of the arc marked on it. This was an instrument developed in the 18th century to help sailors find their position at sea. First, of course, the concern was simply latitude, their distance from the equator, which could be done with a noon sighting on the sun. And knowing what time of year it is, we can know what angle the sun is supposed to be at any given latitude and derive our latitude from there. Longitude was a more complicated calculation. This also got used for measuring horizontal distances between objects on the horizon for surveying, for example, as the chart makers of the Chesapeake would have used. To get a wider angle possibility, this, although it's only 1/8 of a circle, because there are in fact two mirrors on this instrument, it's a double reflecting instrument, we can actually make a 90 degree measurement, find something up to 90 degrees off the horizon, or angles of 90 degrees. And of course for measuring angles between objects on the horizon, a sextant with an arc 1/6 of one circle is even more versatile. And these came in vogue in the 19th century with the wide arc because of their versatility. And for those who learn traditional navigation, this is essentially still the tool. They now make them out of more modern materials, but sextants are still available. And occasionally some people actually learn to use these things in this age of GPS, global positioning system. This particular sextant has a great provenance. And one of the things that we love to do at the Chesapeake Bay Maritime Museum is collect not just representative objects of this sort of history of technology, this history of navigation, but things with particular stories from people. And this particular sextant was used by a sailor by the name of Terence Burroughs. Terence grew up here in St. Michael's, and loved to, on more than one occasion, ran away from home. He was determined to become a sailor, and he went over to Baltimore, and after a couple of attempts, found it was actually rather difficult to sign on to as crew on a ship. Ultimately did, served on a couple of big steamers of his era, first as mess boy and later as a seaman, lookoutman, and all the rest, and managed to get himself a job on a square rigger, an English-built, American-flagged square rigger named the Avon. He worked his way up with all this experience, ultimately became a captain of steamships, worked for the Bull Line. Now, this particular sextant of his was not an American instrument. It's a Dutch-made instrument, which does not mean that he couldn't have bought it in the United States. Because the European-made instruments were, in fact, sold quite commonly to American sailors. But it is marked De Koning Arnhem, the Dutch city of Arnhem. It's also marked with the name of Amsterdam, so presumably they were in a second city by the time they were manufacturing this, around the year 1920 or so. So Terence Burroughs grew up in the early 20th century, in the teens, and early 20s was experiencing those early steamships and that square rigger adventure on which he went on his first voyage over 13,000 miles. Ultimately, if he was going to become a mate or a captain, he had to learn how to find his position at sea, how to become a navigator. So this was an instrument that was really reserved for the officers of the ship, although perhaps a common sailor who was aspiring to become so would learn to use this. Both of these instruments and several others will be going into our forthcoming exhibit. opening on May 19th, exploring the Chesapeake, exploring the Chesapeake, mapping the bay. Please come and join us, and thank you for joining me today on Chesapeake Treasure.